Lord Jesus, reveal the whole of our sin and division. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, repeat us with your body and blood. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Jesus, repeat us with the Father and the Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
One apiece If a family is too small for a whole ram, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one, and shall share the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who will partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you shall eat, with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat it like those in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing that blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations will celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. My brothers and sisters, this is the word of the Lord.
Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Gospel. I'm not doing this with you, man. This is ridiculous.
I'm starving.
No, we're gonna stand here.
I'm starving.
I know you've all heard me comment on how much I love my nieces.
So you can stand here and listen to church. If you cannot be here, then you're gonna stand right here. You're not gonna disrupt everybody else who's trying to sit and listen. Might be being disruptive.
When I visit, especially with the ones that have the younger siblings, excuse me, the younger nieces and nephews, one of the things I know I enjoy, and I know they do also, is story time. I love getting to read them their bedtime stories, and I love getting Uncle Lee to do them. I'm pretty sure the reason is they know that they can get a lot more bedtime stories out of Uncle Ian than they can their own mom and dad. So bedtime gets, delayed a bit. But, have you ever noticed how a good story gets people's attention? When we hear those wonderful words, once upon a time, the child within all of us sits up. We perk our ears. We get ready to listen, to hear a good story. I would love for all of you and myself to be like that child listening to a good story tonight, and in the days to come, tomorrow, the Friday, the Easter Vigil, and Easter Sunday. Our ears should perk up when we hear the Passion read, or yes, even during the many readings of the Easter Vigil that tell us the story, the history of salvation. Now, sadly, there are some who will see them purely as a test of endurance. I had a fellow in one parish I was at that every year he came to the Easter Vigil Mass, and every year he then complained to me about how long the Easter Vigil Mass is. I said, "Dude, you knew that coming here. You've known that for decades." Now, that's not what it's to be like. We should allow ourselves to get caught up in God's great story. A story that is my story. It's your story. From the tree at the center of the Garden of Eden to Christ on the tree of the cross. We're part of the drama. We have fall. We have strength. We have the belief. Each of us can put our own self into this beautiful story. Let's take a try at it like this. Once upon a time, it was the night before Jesus suffered and died. He and his friends had gathered together around tables, just like sitting around table with family and friends gathered around for a good dinner. They had come together like so many of God's people had done for years and years before them. They came together to remember God saving the people from slavery. They would listen to the story of God's mighty deeds, of the angel of death passing over the houses marked with the blood of the Lamb. They would be there. They would be there. They would eat of the Passover lamb. They would mark the door of their house with the blood of the Passover lamb. They would flee from Egypt under God's almighty protection. Now remember during the meal what Jesus did? I mean, what kind of like usual, but then he changed things up a little bit. He took some bread. That was normal, right? That was expected. It was the unleavened bread of the Passover. Kind of like that unleavened bread that we used for the Eucharist, right? It was the bread of a journey. It was the bread of affliction. He blessed it. He broke all pieces of it. He gave them to his disciples. We did something like that a couple nights ago at our own sacred dinner. All of this was normal. not the words you said now. Words that have been remembered and retold throughout history. Words that you and I are going to hear tonight, because he took that bread and he said, eat this. It is my flesh. This is my body. I'm going to give up everything so that you may live. And this wine, the wine in this cup, is my blood. It's my blood. Imagine being there and hearing that for the first time. I will shed it because I love you. Drink deeply of this cup. Jesus gave us his body and his blood as the new Passover lamb. And as if that were not enough, he did something else absolutely unthinkable, unspeakable, unimaginable. You remember what he did. He took a pail of water. He took his cloak off, took a pail of water, and he knelt down and he washed the feet of the disciples. Peter blurts out, oh, no, you don't. Stop it. Not me. You're not going to wash my feet. Probably what we would say. Peter has been coming to understand what we know, that Jesus is the Christ, the Messiah, the Son of God. And this makes Jesus doing this menial task, the task of the servant, absolutely unthinkable. All the more confusing. The Passover, after all, is about being free from slavery. Free from slavery. Back at the beginning of Lent, we remember Jesus being driven by the Spirit out into the desert. And you all remember Satan tempted him, right? The devil tempted Jesus out in the desert. And the temptation basically went, you are equal to God. Act like it. You're equal to God. Act like it. Work some miracles. You don't need to suffer. You don't need to work with labor. You don't need to be humble. Work some miracles. Be the God that you are. And then recall how Peter has tried to stop Jesus from following the Father's plan. Once again, Peter opening his mouth, inserting his foot. Oh no, Jesus, no, we won't go to Jerusalem then. No need for you to suffer, no need for you to die. We'll figure out another plan. We'll figure out our plan. And Jesus said, get behind me, Satan. Those words must have stung, don't you think, right? Those words must have deeply stung. Now Jesus warns Peter again. If I do not wash you, you will have no part in me. Peter, with his mouth hanging open, his eyes full of shock, sat there as the warm water flowed over his feet.
Yes or no?
Jesus washed the bride.
Yes or no? Do you think this is appropriate?
And we remember that tonight.
Yes or no?
Because the human story is one of receiving God's love, accepting God's love, and giving it to others. That's what we
understand. Okay.
We're meant to receive God's love, accept God's love, as God has loved us. If Peter will not allow Jesus to care for him in this earthly way, this seemingly slave-like way of washing his feet, he will be refusing God's gift of love. It will be like saying, no, Jesus, you can't love me then. Jesus is saying, but I have to. That's what Dad sent him to do. That's simply to be humble. That's simply to watch for us. Now, you and I, like those disciples around the Passover table, we don't just remember Jesus breaking bread and sharing the cup as something that took place hundreds of years ago, something far in the past. No. Remember, we're part of the story.
We're all here to sit and watch and be quiet.
It's your story.
Which I know.
Plan.
Listen to me.
Make the rules. Jesus breaks bread and gives it to you, saying, eat this, this is my body. We heard Paul telling us that, right, in our second reading. Take this cup, drink from it. It's the cup of my blood. the blood of the sacrificial lamb that seals the new and eternal covenant. If you eat my body and drink my blood, the angel of death will pass you over, not just for one day, but that you might have eternal life.
God said,
imagine, feel Jesus pouring water on your face. Allow yourself to experience the rough hands of a carpenter holding your teeth, washing from them the dirt and grime of the day's journey. I always imagine that after you wash his friend's feet,
I'm going to go to the dirt green, I'm going to draw the wall.
Show his love.
And I'm going to go to the dirt green by myself.
Listen to him saying, I'm not going to be godly in the way I necessarily should. I'm going to show you what God is really like. I'm going to show you what my mom's plan really is. And I want to show you that it is only in humility that you can truly love and be loved. And I'm going to show you that death is the most humble act of all. I am going to suffer. I am going to die. Tomorrow, Good Friday, he washes us again, this time in the bath of his own blood, flowing his pierced side. Saturday, he lies in that tomb. But Sunday, put one Easter lily on the altar tonight. Remind us that even as we enter into the darkness, even as we enter into the darkness of the tomb, you and I know how the story ends, right? We know what happens on Easter Sunday. We know that the lily, the resurrection, is to come, and that's our story. To hear is to obey. Listen to this story. Listening is the first step in action, in doing. Let us be immersed in this wonderful story, our story of salvation. Then it will go on. Once upon a time, the people of one Catholic family heard the story of Jesus' passing. They heard that story, they knew it was their own. They were there when Jesus said the last supper. They stood by him on the cross. They waited for the tomb, knowing that it would be. They remembered. They did. They did it for others in remembrance of Jesus.
So we can be sitting in that worship because he's going to bring the washing people's feet. He's going to bring the washing people's feet, but we're not going to be able to see it because we're not there.
Having your feet washed, please come and stand. Six individuals on this side, six individuals on this side.
People are going to get their feet washed.
I'm
not
doing.
No, they're not there to do it. While you're waiting for your turn, please do me a favor of reading your substitutions. I would ask, however, if Tom would please come down the woods.
Would you like to watch? Would you like to see? Come see him right now. You'll be able to see him, okay? Thank you.
as the Lord has washed our feet, so now we're called to service to the world. For the church, that we may live like Jesus and spend our lives in loving service, washing the feet, carrying burdens, and comforting the brokenness of one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. For those to whom we are committed, especially our spouses, families, communities, and friends, that we may be faithful to them and a sign of God's love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians who are persecuted, that God will strengthen their faith, renew their courage, and make strong their witness to the gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who serve our daily needs, that those who care for the sick and those who console the grieving and the lonely, that God will renew their strength and fill them with peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of peace, God will bring an end to all war and violence, and allow everyone to recognize the beauty and dignity of human life. We pray to the Lord. For our beloved departed, our personal prayers, those prayed for by our prayer chain, and in a special way at this Mass, for the intentions of Bishop Robert J. McClory. We pray to the Lord. For all tribute to our touch to the sea of peace, which is being paid to household and service for our work, we pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, gracious and fearless, who we bring to the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns with God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please join us in the Our Glory hymn.
Come, sing.
395. Let's sing this song. Number 395.
Go back in the front.
Will you let me in your shirt?
my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God through our mighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the law of his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we might participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat this flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, with the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without him we have heaven.
Celebrating that most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles Peter and martyrs, Peter, Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, Linus, Cleus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, and Cyrus, John, Paul, Hospice, and Damian, and all the saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things, we be defended by your protecting power.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept the salvation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and count that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for our salvation and the salvation of all, he took breath in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised up to heaven, to you, Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
As we await the blessed overcoming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into the room of my Lord, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us in our communion hymn, number 339, The Supper of the Lord, number 339.
Thank you.
Thank you.